Hey there. So I get a lot of questions about using page designer, especially in the recruitment agency industry, for trying to create profiles of talent, of caregivers, things like that. So I wanted to show you some tips and tricks for how to use the page designer app. So first off, if you want a very pretty background and so forth, I have gone to Canva and created one. You'll see here like the employment history and so forth is kind of hard typed into this image, but the person's name and so forth is layered on top of it. So that is, and also too in education and agency notes. So you can do pretty much anything. This is just a very general idea, and it can be completely customized to your own business, obviously. But Canva is a great resource to create kind of those images. And what I do is I attach those images into Airtable. So this one is saved somewhere fancy. But you can create a just a record in here for your background images, and then have an attachment field, and then upload it. And so what you would do is you would do. So what I did here is I just went into Canva and looked up resume. So I'm just going to pick a very simple resume. And I'll just pick this one. And so I'm going to duplicate this page just so the format stays the same. And then I would say that you can just hard type all the information that you want into watch me build stuff in Canva. You can hard type as much as you want in delete group. In the actual Airtable page designer. This is the most complicated one, I'm sure. Delete group. Delete, 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 delete. Don't even know what that is. And then I'll delete this, delete this, delete this, delete that, right? And then I can just duplicate this, right? So you can add more pictures, you can have your logo and so forth. So I'm gonna go ahead and download this as PDFs, as two individual pages. And actually, I'm gonna download it as image files. And so I would do PNGs, and then it would become as two, so you'd have to unzip it. So I'll show you in 1 second when it finishes downloading. I will extract it all. And then I will go back to Canva, and you can't see it because I'm using my screen recorder, which is online, so you can't see what's going on my computer. And so I'm going to upload page one and page two, which are the same in this case, but if you had a different one, upload more. You're gonna be annoying, aren't you? Upload two. So if you had page one and page two, for example, so what you're gonna do is you're going to click on the image and right click. Copy image address. This is going to be page one, and then if you wanted to grab page two, you could. And so I'm going to go back and edit this PDF. And so what I'm doing is I'm going to delete this image, and I'm going to add an image, and I want it to be the same size as this page, which is 927 by 1199. If you wanted a two-page document, you would duplicate 1199 times two, which is, I can't count that high. 1199 times two. is $23.98. So I'm going to change this to $23.98, which will give me 2 pages, right? And then, but you want to know where those page breaks are, right? So the image itself is $9.27, $11.99, right? So that I can know where the page ends, okay? The image URL that I'm pasting in there is the URL of the image that I just picked. I got that image address from Airtable, right? And so there you go. And then I'm gonna make sure it fills. So it's exactly 927 by 1199 for that image. And then I'm going to send to back. So everything else overlays on top. And then the only problem with doing the image first is that it's a little clicky. Like if you click it too much, it won't let you grab the information above and below. Okay. And so like I take the content and I kind of make sure it fits and so forth. And then I move the images around. You'll see that the content, I use a lot of static text boxes that merge the content like field names. So all of these names here are the field names, right? And so if I wanted to copy, for example, if I wanted to add, you know, what languages do you speak? What I would do is I would highlight end to end, what languages do you speak? Go into this text box. The stuff that I want to show up, regardless of whose profile it is, I would type in here. And then where I want the merge information, the information coming from Airtable, I put a curly Q bracket. I paste, and I didn't paste that. I didn't grab that properly. Let me do it one more time. What languages do you speak? I'm copying here. So that I use Control C on Windows. And then I'm going to go back into this text box. Paste. End bracket, just like you use in formulas and so forth in the base, we would do that here. So you could see that it's languages spoken, vampire bites, whatever they're called. And then the merge. And then so I can just delete this field. And then I do the same thing when I'm trying to like combine information from multiple fields in the base. I will put like position for current employer from start date to present. So I have that kind of information. And then I also can move stuff around. And then you'll see that this is the end of page one. So now I want to do a page two. So I'm going to go ahead and close this for a second. I'm going to go here and I'm going to pick up what would be page two. And then again, copy image address. You could use the same image over and over again if it's really the same. But if it's like the first page is like a cover letter and the second page is, you know, the rest of the pages, or one has letterhead, one doesn't, totally up to you. So I'm gonna go back and edit layout, and then I'm gonna go ahead and add another image block. And then again, I'm gonna make it 927, which is the width of the screen of the page, and then 1199, which is the pixel height of a page in Page Designer. And then you'll also see that X is how close to the edge it is. And then Y is how close to the, how vertically it shows on the screen. So this ends at 1199. So by default, this should end at 1200. Otherwise they would overlap. And you can always overlap and so forth, but you see how it goes 1199. So it kind of overlaps. So then you could just make it 1200. You can do this visually as well, but it's just nice to use the coordinates and the pixels just so that you know that you're being exact. And then again, you'll see that the image is shorter, so I just go ahead and fill it. Okay? And then I can add as much information, and then you can also distance willing to travel, pull that in. Now see how this drop down is a bubble? Well, I don't want it to be a bubble. I want it to look like I typed it or whatever. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit C, Control C again, and then stick it in a text box. Curly Q curly Q bracket text box. And then just make sure that you close out that gap. So if you use a text box on a drop down or a multi-select and house the merge field information there, then you would not see the bubbles. You would just see comma, item, 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 comma, whatever. So this is much easier. And then again, just make sure like when you're clicking around a little bit easier. So I hope that's helpful. If you have questions, please drop them below. I'm happy to answer them either via video or another question, you know, another video or in the comments. I can use words. So anyway, so I hope that helps you figure out how to use Page Designer in Airtable. And then again, the possibilities are endless. The reason why I like using Airtable Page Designer is because if you update the information in Airtable, it will update the information automatically in the page. Oh, one other thing. Make sure when you go to print that you print letter size. And make sure it's not custom here, because sometimes when you change the custom up here in the settings, it will change this paper size to custom. Make sure you're still printing out on letter 8.5 by 11, just to make sure that it prints out as multiple pages, just like you intended. It doesn't try to shove everything into one page. And you'll see it loading. And so now you can see it's on two different pages. So I hope that helps. Again, if you have questions, let me know. Other things that you can do inside the text boxes is set the text color, font size. It has pretty much all the Google fonts in here, which is nice. And then the only thing, if you're using a rich text box, it will not let you override the information. And then if you're trying to do a label in bold and then a text that's not in bold, you have to use two different blocks, one for the static text and then one for the text in bold and then the text that's not supposed to be in bold. So you do have to go box by box that information. So let me know if that's helpful, and if you have any questions.